In this video, we're going to finish the independent and dependent worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the geometry section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free KutaSoftware website worksheet. Now, picking up on the second page with number 13, our directions say that events A and B are independent. Find the missing probability. Well, if events A and B are independent, then the probability of A times the probability of B does indeed equal the probability of A intersection B, or A and B. In number 13, it gives us a conditional probability. So remember, the conditional probability formula, P of B given A, will equal the probability of A intersection B, A and B, divided by the probability of A. And we could write the same for the conditional probability of A given B, just that when you take the probability of A and B, you would then divide it by the probability of B. So you're dividing it by the probability of the event that was given. So looking at number 13, it tells us the probability of A, the probability of B, and we're to find the probability of B given A, knowing that these events are independent. So remember that the conditional, the probability of B given A, will equal the probability of A intersection B divided by the probability of A. But if these are independent events, we can rewrite the probability of A intersection B as the probability of A times the probability of B. So the probability of B given A, we can write as the probability of A times the probability of B divided by the probability of A. And the probability of A will cancel out with the probability of A. So we'll have the probability of B given A equal to the probability of B. Therefore, the probability of B given A is equal to the probability of B, which is 3/5. In number 14, we're given the probability of B, the probability of A given B, and the probability of A. So just as we had the conditional, the probability of B given A, we can rearrange for the probability of A given B. So the probability of A given B equals the probability of A intersection B, or A and B, divided by the probability of B. But since these are independent events, we can rewrite the probability of A and B as the probability of A times the probability of B, and that's still divided by the probability of B. So notice that the probability of B will cancel out. So we'll have that the probability of A given B is equal to the probability of A. Therefore, the probability of A equals the probability of A given B, which is 1/5. In number 15, it gives us the probability of A, the probability of B, and we're to find the probability of A and B. So we're just going to multiply the probability of A times the probability of B, and that will equal the probability of A and B. Probability of A is 3/10 times the probability of B of 13/20. So that equals the probability of A and B. 3 times 13 is 39, and we're dividing that by 10 times 20, which is 200. So 39/200 is our solution in number 15 for the probability of A and B, which we could also write as the probability of A intersection B. For number 16, we know that the probability of A times the probability of B equals the probability of A and B. However, this time we're solving for the probability of A, so we're going to isolate that by dividing by the probability of B. So the probability of A will equal the probability of A and B divided by the probability of B. So the probability of A will equal 9 divided by 100, and we're going to divide that by 9/20. But dividing by 9/20 is the same as multiplying by 20/9. I'm simply flipping that fraction. So 20 times 9 equals 180, and 100 times 9 is 900. Simplifying that fraction, I know that 180 goes into 900 5 times, so simplifying, we'll get 1/5, because 180 divided by 180 is 1, and 900 divided by 180 is 5. For number 17, the probability of A equals 2/5, the probability of A and B equals 3/10, and the probability of not B is what we're solving for. So we know that the probability of B will equal the probability of A and B divided by the probability of A, because the probability of A times the probability of B equals the probability of A and B. So the probability of B equals 3/10 divided by 2/5, which we can write as 3/10 times 5/2, flipping that second fraction. So the probability of B equals 3 times 5, which is 15, divided by 10 times 2, which is 20, which we could also write as 3/4, since 5 goes into 15 3 times, and 5 goes into 20 4 times. Now, the probability of not B is equal to 1 minus the probability of B. So we'll take 1 and subtract our probability of B, which is 3/4. 1 minus 3/4 is 1/4. So the probability of not B is 1/4 in number 17. Now in number 18, it introduces the union, the probability of A or B, which we can write as the probability of A union B. So the probability of A union B is equal to the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A intersection B, or the minus the probability of A and B. So if we have the probability of A union B is 173 divided by 200, that's going to be equal to the probability of A, 7/10, plus the probability of B, which is our unknown, minus the probability of A and B, which is the probability of A times the probability of B. So that's 7/10 times the probability of B. So we're going to have to solve for the probability of B. Let's start by subtracting 7/10 from both sides. However, I'm going to rewrite 7/10, multiplying both sides by 20, so that I can get 200 on my denominator, and 7 times 20 is 140. So subtracting 7/10 is the same as subtracting 140 over 200. So that will leave me 173 minus 140 is 33 over 200. Because in order to subtract or add fractions, I need to have a common denominator. And that's equal to the probability of B minus 7/10 times the probability of B, which if we were to multiply the probability of B by 1, or think of this as one whole probability of B minus 7/10 times the probability of B, that will be 33 over 200 equal to 3/10 times the probability of B. So in order to solve, I'll multiply both sides by 10/3. 10/3 and 3/10 will cancel out, so I'll isolate my probability of B. 10 times 33 is 330, and 3 times 200 is 600. So 330 out of 600 equals the probability of B, which, when simplified, I can think of 330 out of 600 as 33 out of 60, which 3 goes into both of those evenly, so that equals 11 out of 20, since 11 times 3 is 33, and 20 times 3 is 60. So 11/20 is my solution in number 18. And that, again, is 11/20, because the probability of A union B, A or B, is the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A times the probability of B, since the probability of A intersection B is the probability of A times the probability of B. In number 19, we're going to find the missing probability. I know that the probability of A given B equals the probability of A and B divided by the probability of B. So that will be 1/10 divided by 2/5, or simply multiplied by 5/2, which will equal 5/20. 1 times 5 is 5, 10 times 2 is 20, so that simplifies to 1/4, since 5 goes into the numerator and denominator evenly. And number 20, I have the probability of A, the probability of B given A, and the probability of A and B. So I know that the probability of B given A equals the probability of A intersection B over the probability of A. So if I multiply both sides by the probability of A, I'll get that the probability of A times the probability of B given A equals the probability of A and B. That's the probability I'm looking for. So the probability of A, 3/5, times the probability of B given A, 3/10, will equal 9/50. So 9/50 is my solution in number 20. In number 21, I have the probability of not A, so let's solve for the probability of A. If I take 1 and subtract not A of 3/5, I'll get that the probability of A equals 2/5, since 1 or 5/5 minus 3/5 is 2/5. So now I can solve for the probability of B given A, since I know that the probability of B given A equals the probability of A intersection B divided by the probability of A. So that's going to be 6/25 divided by 2/5, or multiplied by that flipped fraction, 5/2. 6 times 5 is 30, 25 times 2 is 50, and 10 goes into both of those evenly, so we'll get 3/5 as the probability of B given A. And lastly on this worksheet, the probability of B, the probability of A union B, which is the same as the probability of A or B, and they give us the probability of B given A. We're just missing the probability of A. So I know that the probability of A union B equals the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A intersection B, A and B. So I'm given P of A union B. I need to solve for P of A. I'm given P of B, but I can calculate P of A and B even though I'm not given it. I know that P of B given A, the probability of B given A, equals the probability of A intersection B divided by the probability of A. So if I multiply both sides by the probability of A, I can rewrite my formula to say the probability of A union B equals the probability of A plus the probability of B minus, instead of the probability of A and B, I'll say the probability of A times the probability of B given A. So now my only unknowns are the probability of A. So let's plug in everything else. The probability of A union B is 0.72. That's going to be equal to the probability of A plus the probability of B, 0.45, minus the probability of A times the probability of B given A of 0.4. I'll start by subtracting 0.45 from both sides. So 0.72 minus 0.45, or 0.72 minus 0.45, is 0.27, or 0.27. That's equal to the probability of A minus 0.4 times the probability of A. So 0.27 will equal, think of this as 1 minus 0.4 times the probability of A. 1 minus 0.4 is 0.6. So if we think of this as 1 times the probability of A minus 0.4 times the probability of A, we'll get 0.6 times the probability of A. So all we need to do now is divide by 0.6 to get what that probability of A is equal to. So the probability of A equals 0.27 divided by 0.6, which equals 0.45. So 45 hundredths is the solution and number 22. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't already, like, subscribe, and share.